Hello again from my front porch. Well, it's good to be back home, back on my front porch. This last week, I was down in Florida. I flew down there last Friday and spent the weekend and the early day or two with Josh and Ashley down there. Got to go to church with them on Sunday. Got to hear Josh preach. Got to hear Ashley sing. They let me sing a couple songs. That was fun. I enjoyed that. Getting to hang out with the Broader Moon family, with Rick and Charlene, Josh's parents, and Josh's brother and his wife. And just their extended church family, and it was just all great time down there. And then Monday, Ashley and Josh and I went to Universal Studios Park, to the Islands of Adventure, and to the actual Universal Studios Park. So we do the whole Harry Potter experience, and the other things there. We got to have dinner with Marvel superheroes, and all kinds of fun stuff. And I'm going to be doing other episodes here that I'm going to pre-prepare that are going to focus on some of those things I'll be launching this week, because this week coming up is actually going to be a busy week for me. Activity-wise, not really busy. I'm just primarily filming some training that Waldinger is doing for our service managers, a boot camp for the service managers, and we're wanting to capture all of the content that is used in that. And so I'm going to be videoing that, but those sessions start at 7:30 every morning, and they go all day until like 4 or 5 o'clock. And so that's going to dominate my days most of this coming week. And so I'm not going to have a chance to really do many of these. And so my goal here this weekend is to pre-prepare 2 or 3 episodes that I can then just have saved and ready to just upload and just launch. So that's going to be the goal. But I did want to do this one today because I have some really, really big, important news. And this also... Over the last 2 or 3 weeks, I have felt like a lot of these episodes I begin, the ones that I've done, I've felt like I've started off by saying, oh, you know what, I apologize for not having done many of these. I apologize for this. There's been a lot of apologies that nature. Well, part of the reason for that is because I'm a very bad liar. I can keep secrets, but I'm not really good at it, especially when it's something really exciting and really significant and that is going to have a broad impact on a lot of things, a lot of people. It's tough for me to keep that to myself because there's just so many opportunities to slip up and it becomes nerve-wracking trying to keep tabs on not saying something at the wrong time. And so that's what I've been doing for the past few weeks here, and I apologize for lying to you good folks, but you know, I have to be mindful of the fact that anybody can see these videos, and so there were a lot of things that I had to get in place before I could publicly divulge about this. But here you go. I will be leaving the Waldinger Corporation at the end of April, the end of this month, just in a couple of weeks. They know about it. I mean, I've talked with them before the end of March, and so it's been in the works, and I'm leaving on very good terms. And there's nothing wrong at Waldinger. I'm not leaving because, in fact, I had no incentive to. I wasn't looking. But another company called Baker Concrete Construction. Now, if you're here in the Midwest area, you may be familiar with Baker Electric, based here in Des Moines. No relation, just happened to have the same name, but no relation whatsoever. Baker Concrete Construction is the nation's largest concrete construction company. I mean, they do stadiums and skyscrapers and, you know, massive projects like that, nationwide company. Anyway, they went after me in a big way. They really wanted me, and in fact, I turned them away twice. But the third time was a charm, as the saying goes. But I ultimately decided that what they're asking me to do is an opportunity that I just couldn't say no to. Plus, I mean, I'll be honest, they also bundled with that a very sweet offer package comes with it too. I mean, that's a nice plus, but that wasn't my motivation. It's not about the money, and it's not about, you know, any of that. But the opportunity, they want me to build them a training program that it will be a nationwide training program that does more than just address the needs of their employees. That obviously is the role. But they want the program that is built to almost out of the gate be seen as a gold standard for their industry. They want everybody else in their industry to see the Baker program and go, ooh, oh, so you went to the Baker program? Ooh, wow, that's good stuff. That's their goal. That's what they want. And this goal comes from the CEO and founder of the company on down the line. In fact, he's in his 70s and is looking to, at some point here in the next several years, next handful of years, step away and not be as actively involved. And he personally sees this project as a key element of the legacy he wants to leave behind. That's how significant this project is. And so I'm very excited to get a chance to do that. Again, it's taking the skills that I've been doing and the things that I've been able to use and applying them now in a bigger context, a broader scale. And I'll be leading a team. In fact, I've already met two members of the team that will be reporting to me, and they're great guys. They're based out of the Denver office. They have offices in Denver, Houston, a little town just outside of Cincinnati, which is actually where the company was originally founded. That's where they launched from, so that's why their home office is still there. Cincinnati, in D.C., outside of D.C., and then down in the Fort Lauderdale area. Now, the position that I've taken is going to have the same job title that I currently have, talent development manager. However, they regard it as more of an executive level position, a top leader level position, whereas at Waldinger, it's more of a lower middle management kind of position. And so the structure is just a little different, maybe a little flatter in some ways. But with this group, I will be leading this team, and since they don't have an office in Iowa, there's a good chance that at some point in the next year or so, I may be looking at relocating. And if that happens, most likely I would relocate to the Fort Lauderdale area, because that's where all the other leaders of the company, all the other executive level folks, all office out of Fort Lauderdale. I wouldn't have to. In fact, like I said, the two members of my team that I have so far are based out of Denver. So, you know, might make sense for me to be there, or, you know, Houston or D.C. Nah, not D.C. I like visiting D.C. I don't think I could live there. I think it would drive me insane. But anyway, point is, there is a good likelihood that at some point I will have to relocate. they are graciously going to allow me to remain here in Des Moines for the time being, and that's good, and I'm very happy about that. It allows me to be able to scope things out and really get my footing before I would do that. And at such point that I relocate, assuming again that it happens, I mean, it may not. I mean, we may determine as we're rolling things out Paul's traveling to everywhere he's doing it anyway, and the stuff he's working on independently he can just do from home, so he can stay in Des Moines. You know, that wouldn't be bad either. But at whatever point that I relocate, then they'll cover my relocation expenses, and so that, you know, I can get all transitioned. And so they're being very gracious, very generous in their treatment, and I really like that. I like that. The Waldinger folks also demonstrated their value to me. They were all very sad to see me leave, and I've been hearing lots of individuals, from some surprising individuals, and I only say surprising because they're individuals who I previously have not done a lot with, that have now, as they've heard that I'm going to be leaving, that they have come to me and said that they have thanked me for the work that I've done there and the impact that I've had, and said some pretty lofty, flowery things about me. You know, it's not bad to hear that. It's a little, for me personally, it's a little awkward, because I'm not someone who fishes for compliments. I mean, I like them as much as anybody does, but at the same time, I feel a little uncomfortable when I don't feel like I'm personally responsible, that there's been a whole group effort with this. But I am appreciative of those who acknowledge that I have played a role, and in some cases a significant role, in what Waldinger has accomplished. And I know that the team members I'm leaving behind, they're good, solid people, and they're going to be able to continue working on it. It's not like the program's going to come to an end. And they are advertising to fill my position too. So my training colleagues out there, if you are looking for a really great opportunity, I mean this sincerely, if you're looking for a great opportunity at a great company, working for a great leader and great teammates, Waldinger is forget if you've never worked in construction. I hadn't either before I went to work for them. And now I'm moving on to another construction company, but I'm doing training things, not construction things. And so Don't let that hold you back. Waldinger is a fantastic company, and Dan Dyke, who's been my boss these last 4 years, I could not have worked for a better leader. I'll just simply say that. He's an incredible guy, and I think the world of him and Sherry and Kayla, my teammates, and everybody that I, all the leaders, the subject matter experts, everybody that I've had opportunity to work with there. It really is very sad for me to be leaving. It pains me in a lot of ways. But this is an opportunity that I really felt the need of having to grab onto and go for. Now, the flip side is that even though I will still be living in Des Moines, obviously you heard where all the offices are, so I'm going to be doing some traveling. And so that's going to be coming up as well. And I'll be living here, but flying there. How much? I don't know, but we'll be finding out here very soon in the next couple of weeks. So anyway, that's my exciting news, and that's part of the reason why I've been biting my tongue so much, not doing so many of these episodes, is because I was just afraid I was going to say something. I was going to slip up and say something before I'd had a chance to tell everybody. And at this point now, I've spread the word among coworkers, and I've spread the word among friends, and I've spread the word among family, and I've spread the word among the individuals that I've collaborated with closely in the civic world, the civic groups that I've been part of, and. Unfortunately, in almost all cases, I'm going to have to be stepping away from my roles with them, either because I won't, like Central Iowa Workforce Development Board, I can't represent the Central Iowa business community anymore because my new employer isn't based in Central Iowa, has no employees in Central Iowa. So I can't really represent them that way. Then also the Filipino group with the scholarship committee, I've enjoyed being part of that, but I'm stepping away from that as well because frankly, I'm afraid I won't be around, because of the flying and traveling to all the places that I will not be a dependable volunteer. And so that's what's happening. All right. Well, anyway, I see a wasp flying around here in my front porch. And before he notices me, I'm going to get out. You've noticed me looking. That's what he keeps bouncing around. So I'm gonna get going. Besides, I have a Filipino meeting to get off to, Filipino team meeting thing to get to, and maybe very likely my last one of those. So I better get moving and get off to see those good folks too. So anyway, with that, I'll see y'all next time from my front porch.